Hi everyone, welcome back to Bank Exams Today, and this is our day 11 of 5 minutes vocabulary, and we are going to learn 5 new words today. And before starting this video, let me tell you that if you're liking all these videos that we are making on vocabulary and other subjects, please like the videos, share it with your friends and family members, and do subscribe to our channel, which is Bank Exams Today, so that whenever we upload a new video, you get the notification and you don't miss any of our new videos. Okay, so let's start with the very first word, which is cryptic. Cryptic is an adjective which means it is going to signify or going to tell you a speciality about a noun. Okay, and cryptic will be used before a noun in a sentence because it is an adjective. What is a cryptic? Cryptic is something that is very mysterious and have hidden meaning, something which is not direct. Okay, so cryptic is having meaning that is mysterious or obscure. It should be obscure, like these codes. These codes are not direct and not easy to understand. There are some hidden meanings there, and therefore these are cryptic. Okay, the synonyms are enigmatic, mysterious, that because they have hidden meanings, therefore they are mysterious. Perplexing, because they make you confused, that is why we call them perplexing. Puzzling, obscure and abstruse. Okay, and the antonyms are straightforward, something which is not mysterious, that is straightforward. Or clear, because nothing is hidden, that is why it is transparent and clear. Very certain, it means very sure, there are nothing which is indirect, everything is straight. Example is, although Lalit had a major in archaeology, he could not understand the cryptic symbols on the cave walls. Cryptic symbol means a language written in symbols, and it is cryptic. Cryptic means mysterious and hard to understand. Okay, the second word is foment. Foment means to instigate or stir up. It means to cook something that is going to provoke people's emotions, or you can say aggression. So there is a person who is thinking of hate speech on communalism, and he is cooking up riots. It means he is fomenting riots. He is stirring up something bad, something he's conspiring against nation, and in case he starts delivering his hate speech, then it will cause into some unpleasant situations. Foment means to antagonize people, to provoke people to do something in aggression. Okay, so the synonyms are incite, provoke, agitate, excite or arouse. There are other synonyms that you can study in the PDF. Antonyms are end, means you are starting something here, you are fomenting something, and when you end it, fomenting, opposite is end. Neglect, finish, tranquilize, because here you are just amplifying the severity or the seriousness of the situation, but here in the antonym you tranquilize it, tranquilize to pacify it. Discourage or destroy. Example, the celebrity liked to foment rumors by posting cryptic statements. Cryptic statements, statements which have mysterious meanings about her private relationship online. Okay, so foment relationship or foment rumors means to cook up rumors. Okay, so the third word is expunge. Expunge is to delete everything completely or remove everything completely so that other person can start over. So this expunge is basically used with the crimes or criminal records. When we expunge the criminal records, which means the authority or the judges are giving the criminal to start over a new life. All his criminal records are deleted and he has a chance to start a new life. So expunge means to erase something, remove something completely, delete something or cancel. It can be extinguish, eliminate, and abolish. So expunge means clear, wipe out everything. Something is written here and I just delete it so that I can start over. Antonyms are add, because when you delete something you have to add something new. Establish, build, construct, create, or allow. Example should be, the president has the power to expunge any person's criminal history. It means to delete a person's criminal history in order to give that person a fresh start in life. Fourth word is withering. This is an adjective and there is a word wither, which is a verb and it means to destroy. But withering means to make someone feel humiliated. You comment on somebody's appearance, on somebody's clothes, on somebody's behavior or nature that make other person insulted or humiliated. That is called withering. Like this, Mr. Obama is looking at a person with withering eyes or withering look. It means he is mocking at the person or he is trying to make scornful remark on somebody. So withering means being scornful, to make fun of somebody or to look at somebody with derision or look down upon somebody. Then mocking, sneering, and disdainful. So when you don't like someone, suppose someone arrives at a party in a very simple attire which does not match the occasion, and you look at like this, what kind of clothes is she wearing? That is called withering. I commented so that she feels humiliated. Okay, so don't do this. Antonyms are encouraging, because withering is discouraging someone. So antonym should be encouraging, admiring, inspiring, and supporting. Example, a withering look from his wife silenced him. So his wife looked at him with scorn in the eyes and he is silenced. The last word for today is stead. Stead means something which is very respectable, something very subtle, and does not show emotions or excitement. Like this person, whatever you say, he is just sitting like this. No emotions, blank face. There is all seriousness on the face. That means that person is not able to show emotions and not adventurous. So he is respectable and unadventurous. Synonyms are sedate, respectable, quiet, serious. Like if there is a teacher who does not laugh at all, that person is tired, because she is respectful, she is unadventurous, she does not like to show her emotions at all. Serious-minded and steady. Antonyms are excited, because if you are not subtle, you are not calm, you are excited. Indecorous, adventurous, and frivolous. Example, my stat professor was not impressed when I told a joke about my missing assignment. Stat professor, a professor who does not like to show his or her emotion. Okay, like this. Whatever you say, he is going to sit like this. So this is all about today's video, day 11. And I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like it. Please share it and do subscribe to our channel. And if you want to download the PDF, it is available in the description box. So download it and you can take the prints as well. And thank you for watching this video. I'll see you tomorrow.